Let me guess. You're standing in front of Sirig, bounty hunter nonpareil, because you've a mind to aid me in filling the dread Phronēsis. Do I have the right of it? Or do I have the right of it? Willing to throw a cousin to the wind and strike off to battle with a nigh indomitable foe, eh? Why, I've got a feeling the two of us will get along just fine. Allow me to elaborate. Phronēsis isn't your run-of-the-mill straight sin eater. He's one of the nastiest the realm has seen, formed from the remains of one of those goddamn warriors of light. There are four of them all told. Crawled up from the bowels of the deepest hell after being buried for now on a century, if the tales are true. People have come to call them the Carnival Virtues. Before he was transformed into a Sin Eater, Phronēsis was none other than Archmagus Nonobert, whose baleful magics were feared the realm over. Though it's only been a few short years since he first showed up in Almerang, he's already preyed on far too many innocents with his foul sorcery. Non-keen on seeing their trade routes disrupted, the local merchants have placed a healthy bounty on his head. Of course, I'd like nothing more than to fell the fiend single-handed and claim the entire bounty for myself. Unfortunately, circumstances have dictated that I recruit a companion. That's where you come in. Provided that you can prove to me that you possess the rather, specialized set of skills that I require, I promise I'll make it worth your while. Not a bad offer, wouldn't you say? If you fancy yourself up to the task, come find me in Almerang. I mean to set off for there shortly. So you came. It's good to see someone who isn't all talk. As fortunate would have it, another Sin Eater, a far less imposing specimen than Phronēsis, of course, has been sighted just to the west of here. Prove to me you have the skill to back up your words, and we'll talk further. Good show, friend. I wasn't sure what to expect from you, but seeing you in battle has left me with little doubt. Seems I found myself a formidable ally. And so I'll extend the offer in earnest. Help me hunt down Frono, and we'll split the bounty down the middle. Well, what do you say? That's the spirit. Now there's more you should know before you proceed. Come with me to Mordsuk, my base of operations, and I'll fill you in on the details. Welcome to Mordsuk, friend. As you can see, it's a bustling trading post frequented by merchants from across the realm. At least it was before Frono showed up and started preying on unwitting travelers, hence the bounty you see. The lucrative reward has attracted the attention of one capable bounty hunter after the next, yet the fiend still roams free. You can probably imagine why. Those few who have seen Frono and returned to tell the tale speak of the great horrors they witness. Cavernous black holes materializing out of thin air, swallowing everything around them into the abyss. People have taken to calling them the Hollows. Rumor has it that one barely has time to lay eyes on Frono before he summons forth the Hollows, which proceed to consume everything in sight. And I do mean everything. Just the other day, an entire caravan was devoured by the Hollows, leaving only nothingness behind. Mages have postulated that these holes are literally tears in the fabric of our reality, gateways to other worlds, to put another way. At any rate, suffice to say that the next man to come back from the void will be the first. And yet, there's something odd about it all. Witnesses say that Frono doesn't seem to go out of his way to prey on people or settlements. He simply shambles across the wastes, So many hollows, one after the next, and the destruction follows as a matter of course. Needless to say, drawing too near to the fiend is tantamount to suicide. Even attacks from afar have been all but futile, as Phronēsis simply summons the hollows to consume every incoming arrow. With every conceivable means of attack foiled, even the most savvy bounty hunters have all but thrown up their hands, even though the bounty now stands at some 9 or 10-fold the original amount. I am of a different mind, however. The way I see it, if only there were a way to neutralize the hollows, we'd more than stand a chance against Phronēsis himself. This is why I require your services. Your easy triumph over the Sin Eater spoke clear. You're a mage of no common skill. If anyone has the arcane knowledge and aptitude to help me figure out a way to defend against the hollows, it's you. Don't worry, I fully intend to shoulder my share of the burden. And so I plan to gather all the information we need before asking you to put yourself in harm's way. And with that, I best get to work. Once I've formulated a proper plan of attack, we'll talk again. Until then, I suggest you continue to hone your casting skills. The battle that awaits us will not be an easy one. Ah, there you are. And your timing couldn't be any better. As luck would have it, a little bird told me that Phronēsis was sighted in the vicinity not long ago. Don't you worry, I have no intention of rushing in like a fool. My plan is to shadow the Sin Eater from afar, that we might observe the hollows with our own eyes and formulate a suitable plan of attack. To that end, I procure this mannequin here from a merchant acquaintance of mine at the Crystarium. By setting it on Phronēsis's trail, I mean to gauge just how wide of a berth we must keep from the fiend so as to not be sucked up into the void. Shed no tears for the little fellow, friend. His sacrifice will be the key to our success. And yet, as you can see, he's not quite in the best state of repair. Pray lend me a hand in procuring what we need to get him back on his feet. You're a lifesaver, friend. I just spotted a nasty-looking sandskin sibyl lurking about to the east of here. And I do believe one of their tendons should serve well to put some spring back in the little fellow's step. Snag one for me, and I'll see to the repairs. Any luck finding that tendon? For my part, I've acquired something that should serve as a makeshift gear. It cost me an arm and a leg, but hey, if it helps us claim that bounty in the end, it'll be more than worth it. Sibilis tendon. The sinewy, stretchy tendon of a sandskin sibilis. Yum yum. Perfect! Yes, I reckon this is durable and elastic enough to replace the mannequin's snap dry belt. I'll fetch my toolbox and get started straight away. In the meantime, why don't you scout us out a suitable lookout point? Phronēsis was last sighted just southeast of town. Try to find us a spot on higher ground out of sight for the main thoroughfare. Oh there, friend. As you can see, our clockwork friend is back in tip-top shape. And since it appears you found us the perfect lookout spot, why don't we get down to work? I'll kindle us a fire. We might be here for a while. Well, I'll be. There's the bastard. Look closely now, and hold your gaze. You must witness the sheer horror with your own two eyes. No, we mustn't send out the mannequin too soon. If Phronēsis sees it, he may very well blast it to bits before he has a chance to investigate the hollows. Thank you. And there he goes. I'll send the mannequin in to trail him. Let's sit back and enjoy the show. Just as I expected, gone without a trace. Shed no tears for our little friend. Through his sacrifice, we now know just how much distance we must keep from the hollows to avoid being sucked into the void. Now it's our turn. Let's edge a bit closer and see what we can observe. Mind you, take care not to wander too close, lest you fancy vacation to a dark, shadowy abyss. I'm no stranger to the void. It's as if a shadowy whirlwind rages inside, ready to suck anything and everything into the void. I've seen many a horrific sight in my day, but this sends a shiver up the spine. Let me out! It's so dark in here! Huh? Why the pale face, friend? It looks as if you've seen a ghost. A voice, you say? From inside the hollow? That's impossible. Is anyone out there? Please, help me! Help me get out of here! Was that a voice? Is someone out there? You can hear me, please. You must help me. I can't see anything. No road, no trees, not even an ether current to follow. Which way do I go? How do I get out of this place? This voice, what in the God's name is it saying? Needs help. The voice of a boy, you say? Claims he's lost inside with no ether current to follow. Sounds like he's adrift in the flow, not unlike what would happen if an etherite to which one was teleporting was destroyed mid-journey. Wait a minute. What if there were some way you could channel your ether into the void? Might that not allow your etheric form to serve as a beacon of sorts to guide the child back to us? Of course, not that I know how we'd go about that. Huh? You reckon you could do just that? I won't even think of asking how. Do your damnedest. Wicked White! I knew you were no ordinary sinner, but even still you find ways to surprise me. Where am I? Well, I'll be damned. There was a child inside. Our little expedition has left us with more questions than answers, eh? But for now, this boy needs our care. Let us hurry him back to Marzuk and find him a warm bed and some nourishment. The boy's resting now. He is weak, but not wounded, at least as far as I can tell. Needless to say, his presence raises questions. Are there others trapped on the other side of the hollows? If so, might they also be returned to our world alive? There's much we must ask him when he awakes. On another subject, this might be an odd question, but have you ever looked after a child before? You don't say. In that case, he's all yours. I'm jesting, friend. Can't very well tie you down here forever. Worry not. I'll manage somehow. I suppose the first order of the day should be to get some food in his belly. He does look terribly pale after all. Methinks I'll go hunting for some meat. No, perhaps I should take him to a physician first. After all, he may be suffering from some ailment inscrutable to the eye. Or maybe I should... Damn it all, I know I wasn't cut out for this. Ah, there you are. You'll be happy to know that the boy is awake and seems to be no worse for the wear. Physically speaking, at least. There's just one rub, you see. He has no recollection of where he came from, or just how he managed to get swallowed up into the void. In fact, other than his own name, Tanor, he can't remember much of anything at all. He seems a good lad, mind you. Eats my half-hour's cooking with a smile and a word of complaint. Yet I reckon he's hurting inside and badly. We must reunite him with his parents with all due speed. I suggested that he go for a stroll around Mordsuk, and the hopes that the sights might help to jog his memories. He can't have wandered far. Why don't you go check up on him?
Do not tell me. You're the one who rescued me from the flow, yes? I feel from you the same warmth that reached out to me when I was adrift in the ether.
Well, I'll be damned. The boy's a sharp one. And that's not the least of it. The carer who examined him said they could feel great power welling up from within him. Despite his young age, Tanor here seems to possess a remarkable command of the magical arts.
Perhaps I do, and yet, I cannot say. Try as I might, I can recall nothing of who I am or where I came from. Only the darkness.
No need for apologies, boy. You did well just to make it back to us. Speaking of which, can you remember anything at all of what you felt when you were adrift in the void?
That I remember, or at least I think I do. I recall a vague sensation of someone passing alongside me. Indeed, I believe this is what roused me from my slumber.
Huh. If the hollows truly are a gate between worlds, that would mean that someone recently traveled from ours to another, or from another to ours, but that's the possible... Or is it?
You know something I don't, friend. Worry not, I won't pry for details.
Oh well, no sense racking our brains over matters beyond our comprehension. Let's concentrate on what we can do. Namely, find the boy here at home. No doubt his memories will come back to him in due time.
You truly do that? For me? But the two of you have already saved my life. I couldn't possibly burn you any further.
Huh, it's no burn at all. Besides, if we can figure out just who you are, and where you came from, it just might lead us to the answers we seek.
Now let's consider the options. One possibility is that you're an orphan, all alone in this world, not a soul to care for or look after you. And yet this seems unlikely. Yes, the mystical powers you possess say otherwise. You are truly as skilled in magic as they say. Then it stands to reason that someone trained you in the art. Who this master of yours is, and whatever you are, and whether you are of their blood or simply receive their tutelage, this I cannot say. But either way, I'm certain they are worried sick about you.
If that truly is so, I would very much like to meet this person too.
That settles it then. Let's get down to business. I took the liberty of inquiring around Mordsuk and the Crystarium. Unfortunately, there have been no reports of missing persons matching Tanor's description. Which means that we have no choice but to take our search elsewhere. I know of a merchant in town whose travels often take him far afield. Let us have a talk with him and see if he's heard any helpful rumors.
Rumors of a missing boy, you say?
Funny that you ask. It's a long shot, I reckon, but I overheard something the other day that might be of use. On my way to Mordsuk, I stopped over at the inn in Journey's Head. There I met an ailing mage. As the carriers told it, he had been ambushed by a Sin Eater, and was separated from his child in the battle. Bloody hills. Could it be? The Sin Eater that attacked the poor man was Phrono. That would explain everything. This man you speak of, he could be my father? We must go to him at once. Agreed. I only hope that the man is... No, there's no point in presuming the worst. Let us make for the inn and see what the carriers there can tell us. Oh there! I hear there's a mage in your care who's lost his boy. Well, I do believe we have him right here. Huh? I fear there must be some mistake. The boy in question has already been found. This is him, right here. What? So it was my father after all. This boy with you, he too has been separated from his family? Just so. We heard that a man here was looking for his son and we just hoped... Alas, it seems it wasn't meant to be. But there are many people here, yes? Might I ask around and see if any of the others are my family? But of course, yet many of the people here are quite ill and in many cases in considerable pain. It is not a place for a young child to walk around unattended. Indeed it's not. Guess that means either myself or Dalara here should accompany him. I'll go with him. The walk might help me, take my mind off things. Not a bad idea, if the lad doesn't mind. I reckon Tanner would rather be with someone of his own age. Take his mind off things. Speaking of which, how's the boy's father holding up? I fear the poor man has already departed on his journey. He is a man no longer. The child insisted upon staying by his father's side until the last. I permitted this out of respect for him, though part of me regrets the choice. None so young should suffer such horrors. It was some small solace to learn that he has living relatives who reside the Crystarium. In fact, I was just making preparations to escort him there myself. I see. Reckon we should also find someone to look after Tanner as well. Don't get me wrong, friend. I haven't given up on the prospect to find the boy's family. But we have no other leads, and a deadly Sin Eater is still on the loose. If the lad tags along with us every step of the way, he's far more likely to end up dead or worse than to ever reunite with his family. Here's what I propose. We find someone to watch after Tanar for the time being, get back on the hunt, and gather whatever clues we can about his origins along the way. Aye, that goes without saying. Let us have a talk with the proprietor of the Wandering Stairs. He's a kindly enough chap, and knows damn near everyone in these parts. With any luck, he'll be able to direct us to a willing and able guardian. Look, I don't like this any more than you do, but it's the best we can do for the boy given our circumstances. At any rate, let's find him and share the news. Don't worry, it's my decision. I tend to take responsibility for it. Bad news, friend. I've seen the two young ones got into a quarrel of sorts and Tanner's up and run away. Seems the lad mentioned how he'd come out from one of the hollows. The other boy put two and two together and figured he's been attacked by a sin eater.
Then I said, my dad was attacked by a sin eater. And then he turned into one himself. So I asked, what if you turn into a sin eater too?
Tanner's face went all white. He kept saying,
What do you mean? Over and over and over again. I couldn't take it anymore. Before I knew it, I was shouting at him, shut up, just shut up, I bet you're turning into a sin eater already. Why'd I say such a mean and nasty thing?
Don't be so hard on yourself, lad. Both of you have had a rough go of it these past few days. Nobody could blame either of one of you for feeling a bit on edge.
But we must hurry and find Tanner before he comes to harm. Let's split up. I'll search to the west and you take the east. And be careful out there.
When I heard the clamor of battle, I feared the worst.
But I can see that you have everything under control.
Are you okay, lad?
Forgive me, I don't deserve this kindness. I was just so scared. I was worried about what would become of me if I never recovered my memories. But then I started thinking, what if I ended up like that boy's father? What if it's already happening to me?
That's one matter you need to worry yourself with. The cure who examined you told me as much. You suffered no direct wounds. You're in no more danger of turning into a sinner than Delora or me.
Is that so? That's good to hear. But I must apologize to that boy. I should have known better than to badger him about such things, especially after what happened to his father.
Funny thing that. He was saying the same thing about you. You both have good hearts, lad. And you've been through more than any man should. There's no need to be ashamed about your feelings.
There is still so much I do not understand about this world. Why does no one here know of me? Am I doomed to be alone for the rest of my days? Why must it be this way? If only I could remember something. Anything! I'm sick of not knowing who I am. I'm sick of being alone.
Now it's your turn, Tanner, and do not be disheartened by your last attempt. Even the greatest of mages have known failure.
Your command of magic is the equal of my own. If I can succeed, there is no reason why you can't. Free your mind to worry and focus. Thank you, Norbert. I shall try my best.
Wicked White. Are you alright, Delora?
I remember now. I was standing here on these blighted plains. My head hung low in shame. Then, now Bird turned to me with a smile and heartening words.
Now, Bert, why does the name sound so familiar?
I reckon we must have discussed, but not in this godforsaken place. Let's head back to the inn and see if we can't get to the bottom of this.
Tanner, are you alright? I'm so sorry, I shouldn't have said those nasty things.
Forgive me for reacting as I did, I'm fine. In fact, I seem to have recovered some of my memories.
Really? Now that's wonderful! Maybe you won't feel so scared and alone anymore.
I'm leaving to go live in the Crystarium with my relatives. Promise me you'll come visit? I mean, after you get your memories back and all, of course.
That's a promise. Until next time, my friend.
I knew that you two would work things out. Now, let's return to Mord Suk. We have more than our share of questions that need answering.
As I saw it, first you fainted all of a sudden. When you came to, a portion of Tanner's memories had returned. What in the world happened out there?
The power to look into the past, eh? And you're certain that what Delar described matches up with your recollection of the past? I don't know how to break this to you, lad, but your friend Albert that was with you that day, he's no ordinary boy. He's none other than the very man who became Frono, one of those goddamn warriors of light. If he was just a young child in your memories, that means that what you saw took place over 100 years ago. Well, that it were just a coincidence, another boy with the same name. But no, judging from the formidable command of magic, we can only assume it was him.
On the way back, I managed to recall some more about Nelbert and myself. We were taken in by a group of mages, a consentorium of sorts. They were searching for a means to open a hole to another world, and were recruiting young children with high magical aptitude for the task. Nelbert and myself were the two they chose.
You can't be serious. And yet, that would explain the Senator's ability to summon those damned hollows. And if you possess the same knowledge and training as Nalbert did, it could also explain why you were able to survive in there all that time. But what I don't understand is, why haven't you aged at all?
I cannot say for sure, and yet my memories, they're slowly coming back to me. In time, I may be able to help you find a way to close the hollows.
You'd be a lifesaver if you could. But don't overburden yourself, you're still recovering after all. In the meantime, don't worry, Delar and I will see to that you're safe.
I thought Tanner was just a victim of the Sin Eater. To think he was actually friends with the man himself, back when he was still a man. This can't be simple coincidence. Yes, I'm convinced of it now. The child holds the key to defeating Frono. We must keep him safe and not let him out of our sights. Besides, look at how hard he's trying to recover his memories. I'm not so heartless as to kick the poor lad aside before he's figured matters out.
Well, we can't very rush things. You and I will continue to prepare for the battle ahead, while waiting for the rest of Tanner's memories to come back to him.
Ah,
Ah, that is to say, if it's all right with you, lad.
I'm so sorry. I couldn't possibly burn you any further.
Look, lad. I've only known you a short while, but I can tell you've a good heart and a good head on your shoulders. I can only begin to imagine the horrors you've been through, not to mention the fears and uncertainty you face even now. But I want you to promise me this. No more apologies. You are no burden to us, not in the least. You're a valuable member of our band, and as long as you're willing, I want you with us. Isn't that right, Delara?
I see. Thank you, Sirig. Thank you, Delara. I will aid your quest whenever way I can.
Now that's more like it. We're counting on you, lad. Good news, friend. Tina here has told me that his memories are starting to come back to him.
There is one recollection in particular he says he's eager to discuss with the two of us. Tell us, lad. What is it?
As times go by, memories of my earlier days return to me piece by piece.
Nalbert and I were born to members of a great consortium of mages. From our earliest years, we were tutored in the magical arts by some of the realm's greatest scholars. The Consistorium's leaders sought to find a way to open a hole in time and space, a portal to other worlds from which they could summon forth beasts of great power. Now Burr and I were chosen to participate in the research.
Summoning great beasts from beyond our world? You're a mage, Alara. Is that even possible? Void Scent? Never heard of them, but I'll take that answer as a yes. Mages come up with the damnedest ideas, eh? And yet, I don't understand. Why ever would they use two young boys for such a dangerous experiment?
The beasts our masters sought to summon reside in the plains most distinct from our own. Reaching across such a great distance requires a tremendous store of innate ethereal power. And so our masters set about to breed the perfect mage. Marriages were arranged to wed the mightiest members of the Consistorium to one another, in hopes that they would bring forth children of theretofore unheard of magical aptitude. Finally, they succeeded.
And so you were born, and Albert.
Indeed. From even before we could speak, we were taught the complex incantations required to breach the boundaries between worlds. We practiced these spells day after day, night after night for what seemed an eternity. At long last, we were deemed ready to attempt the summoning. Sadly, the experiment ended in failure. The pull from beyond the rift was too strong to resist, and I was sucked into a hall of my own creation. There I remained, trapped, alone, and adrift in that empty void, till Delara called me back to this world. Alas, over a century had passed since that fateful day.
That's the one thing I still don't understand. If so many years have truly passed, why is it that you have not aged even a whit?
I cannot say for certain, but I remember the words of one of my teachers. The rift is not unlike a border between countless worlds, a place that exists beyond time and space. If it is true that the rift exists outside of our concept of time, then it is all too possible that even seconds spent in that empty pocket could correspond to months, years, or decades in our world.
And so you've returned to us just as you were that day, even while over a century has passed for the rest of us. But why didn't Nalbert save you? Shouldn't it have been as simple as opening up another portal to the void where you trapped? The personal dimension.
I fear that would be close to impossible. Opening the portal and reaching as far into the rift as we did required all of our energies to be focused in unison. So in losing you, not only did Nalber lose his friend, he lost his only chance at saving you. Huh. Talk about being a dealt rough hand. Fear not. I have a good news to share as well. I do believe I managed to recall the incantations needed to summon and manipulate the hollows. Summoning beasts from beyond the rift is far beyond my powers, but I just might be able to seal up the hollows Phronēsis so enjoy summoning. What say you, friends? Shall I give it a try? Oh-ho! Now that's music to my ears. Let's not be too hasty. After all, the last time you tried to use this magic, there was some complications, to say the least. Yes, we must take the necessary precautions before confronting Phronēsis in earnest. Let us meet outside the village where Tanner can test out his magic safe from harm. Wicked White, you did it, lad! Sadly, I have not the strength to reach further beyond, nor keep the portal open for more than a few moments. No, I will need further training before I can face. Phronēsis, where in the hells did that bastard come from? Damn it all, I'm too close, I can feel it pulling me in. No, Nalbert! These are my friends! You mustn't hurt them! This isn't good. The cave-in's completely sealed off the tunnel behind us. We've no recourse but to press on with our companions. You heard her. What'll it be? I suppose it falls to us to slay the beast and collect the bounty. Perhaps you and your band would care to take the lead. Ah, spare me your japes. You've no intention of giving up your prize. Mind you, I too made a promise to my companions, a promise I mean to keep. Bah, I told you that splitting up was a bad idea. If Brandon and Rhonda Ray were here, the second-rate spellcaster would be no match for us. Now, Saiva, let's not forget who's our true foe is here. Limit? You're certain that if we slay this monstrosity, the cave-ins will cease. According to the miners, the beast was first sighted on the same day the tremors began, its very presence sucking the mountain dry of its ether. We dwarves know these caves as well as we know our own bodies. Trust me. Then I suppose we'd best make short work of it before everything comes crashing down. Hey, where do you think you're going? My apologies. I took your ceaseless prattling as an invitation to proceed on my own.
think yourself clever, do you? You have uncommon confidence to think you can fell the beast without aid. Answer me this. Why is it you are so intent on claiming the bounty for your own? The bounty? Why, indeed. At any rate, unless you have a mind to stand around here until we all get crushed, we best be moving on, yes? Finally, something we can agree on. And so, I have a proposal. Let's say we band together until our battle heroes won. The tremors grow stronger. No doubt a cave-in is imminent. Let us vanquish the enemy with our combined strength and quit this place before it becomes our tome. Until the battle is won, then. After that, I go my own way. We've done it. Now, to find ourselves a way out. Tremors continue, but why? The fiend has been vanquished and its aether returned to the mountain. We were wrong. No, it was not the creature itself that was causing the quakes. Yes. The crystal courses with nigh inconceivable power. A vast wellspring of ether accumulated over the ages. Yes, the beast was but a hungry creature, drawn here by the stone as was I. You had no interest in the bounty all along. The stone has been left unchecked for too long. The sheer volume ether it houses now is so vast and overwhelming, it threatens to bring the entire mountain down. For how many years have I searched for it, this precious relic that could afford me the power needed to save my friend? You mean to take the stone from this place? But then, what would happen to the mountain? If the ether is not returned to the earth, it is but a matter of time until the mine collapses. The miners, those who live at the foot of the mountain, countless lives will be lost. There's no time. What can we do? Tanner, my friend. Damn it. Damn it all. The tremors have stopped. Tanner, pray forgive me. I promise you this, as long as I walk this earth, I shall never, never give up hope. The stone was yours to do with as you please, and still you chose the fate of many over that of your friend. In return for your sacrifice, I would make you an offer. Come with us. Let us join you in your search for a means to save your comrade. The life of an adventurer isn't an easy one, but I dare say you strike me as the sort who just might enjoy it. So what say you? We'll travel the realm together and lend your strength to whatever unfortunate souls we encounter along the way. And who knows, before you know it, we just might stumble upon a way to rescue your tainer. I will like that very much. Tanner, forgive me. I may have failed you today, but mark my words. For as long as I walk this land, I will not abandon hope. I will find a way to bring you back to us. But today, I must find myself in the company of new companions. And for now,
I must lend them my strength, just as they lent theirs to me.
Delara? Are you alright?
Worry not, Phronēsis is long gone. I launched a few arrows in its direction while it was distracted by Tanner's spell, and just stole away. Anyhow, I'm just glad you're awake and on your feet again. Come now, let us hurry back to Marzuk before the bastard has a change of heart and comes back for us. You really gave us a scare back there, clutching your head in pain with the deadly sinner in plain sight. Let me guess, you had another one of your visions, didn't you? Why take me? So that's how Nelbert and Ardbert met up. Just goes to show you that in times of crisis, even the bitterest of rivals can turn fast friends. Now let's see if I have this straight. Nelbert made it his life's mission to save Tanner here. Knowing that his own energies wouldn't suffice, he went in search of a relic that would afford him the etheric power needed to reach beyond this world. And deep in the mines that day, he found it, yet in the end he decided to sacrifice the stone and his own cause to save the lives of the countless innocents who called the mountain home. And so did he take his first step down the path of a hero, a warrior of light. So that's why he came back to this place, why he still summons the hollows as he did so many years ago. Aye, there can be no doubting it. Even now that he's become a sin-eater, bereft of memory, reason, and any sense of his own actions, the ghastly shell of what was once Nelbert still haunts the wastelands, searching for a way to bring back his old friend. I only knew him as a child, and the whole idea of sin-eaters and warriors of light, it was all so new to me. Even as the pieces came together, I could not truly believe that Nelbert and this Phronēsis were one and the same. When our gazes first met, standing out there in the waste, in an instant, I knew it without question. This was my friend, a friend who had been searching for me for all these years. At last, I know what I must do. I must stop Phronēsis that my dear friend may finally find peace. Thank you, my friends. In the battle, I was able to push Phronēsis Hollow away from Sarig, if only for a short distance. With more training, I'm certain I can learn to close them up entirely. After all we've already seen from you, I've no reason to doubt you. If you're game, so are we. Finally, some cause for hope, eh? But still, we must exercise caution. The last time the boy worked his magic, our foes showed up faster than you can save Phronēsis. While this might be simple coincidence, the likelihood is high that the casting of the spell itself summoned the Sin-Eater to us. You best avoid casting any similar incantations until we prepare for the final confrontation. I want you to stay close for now. Devote yourself to your studies, and hone your skills to whatever degree you can in the safety of the village. And in the meantime, Delara and I will redouble our training efforts as well. Should we succeed in finding a way to counteract the hollows, it will come down to our firepower versus our foes. We must be at full strength for the battle, lest we allow victory to slip between our fingers. That look in your eyes. Yes, I can see that you have gained much strength since we last met. You'll be pleased to hear that Tanner has managed to make steady progress in his training as well. The boy believes he has regained much of the knowledge and skill he possessed before getting sucked into that pocket of time and space. An admirable feat, considering that it was not long ago that he could scarcely remember his own name. And yet, there is one aspect of his training that has yet to be addressed. Put simply, the boy lacks experience in battle. To work the magic necessary to seal out the hollows, I must maintain perfect focus and clarity of mind. If the battle with Phronēsis is my first, I fear my concentration will be disrupted all too easily. And so I thought I'd take the boy out into the wilds, that he might acclimate himself to the battlefield, and further hone his command of magic in the process. And yet, we must keep a wide berth for Amarang. Were we to encounter Phronēsis before we are fully prepared, the results could be disastrous. And so, I propose that we go on an excursion of sorts. Would you be willing to accompany us? I believe there is much the boy could learn from your example. Excellent. Then let us make for Lakeland. The beast in the forest of the Lost Shepherd shall provide a fair challenge for the lad. Ah, there she is. Now, shall we get down to... Is something the matter? How do you like my new clothes, Alara? Not only are they stylish, why, I can just feel the power welling up from deep within me. They're a present from Sirig. Isn't he the best? It was a simple investment, nothing more. We must seize every possible advantage if we hope to triumph over our foe. But enough idle chit-chat. We have work to do. Delara, I would ask you to begin by setting an example for the boy, showing him precisely how you conduct yourself in battle. We cannot very well just toss him to the Wolverines all on his own, now can we? So why don't you get out there and hunt one down for us? Tanner, watch carefully and let Delara show you how it's done. That was incredible! The sheer destructive power of your spells, the way you seamlessly weaved one incantation after the next, everything! But tell me, what would you say is the most important thing a mage should keep in mind when doing battle with a fearsome foe? Ah, but of course! Thank you, Delara! I will endeavor to put everything I've learned from you into practice. Well, here goes nothing. Dread, where do I... No, that's not... Curses, just... Stay still so I can hit you already. Steady now, don't let the enemy fluster you, keep your focus. Right, focus. You're a feisty one, aren't you? Ow, that's smart. Gah, I've seen enough of this. Oh dear,
That didn't go nearly as well as I'd hoped.
Don't get so down on yourself, lad. I shouldn't have jumped in the way I did. I dare say you were starting to get the hang of it there at the end.
I thought it would be a simple enough task to follow Delara's lead. But when that savage creature stared me down, I was too flustered to put what I learned into practice.
Indeed. It is not the strength of your magics that is the issue. You simply must learn to compose yourself.
What do you think, Delara? Are there any other words of wisdom you might offer me? Thank you. I'm sure you're right. I can't allow my foe to break my concentration like this. Anyhow, let me try once more. This time will go better, I promise you.
Yes, the boy will be fine. I must stay my hand.
I did it! The battle is won.
Now that's how you wallop a wolverine. Well done, lad. I'm proud I could be here for your first victory.
You're far too kind. I couldn't have done it without you and Delara here to show me the way. You have my thanks.
But don't let up now, boy. You must keep battling until all that you have learned becomes second nature. Now, are you ready?
That was rather more difficult than I expected. And yet, thanks to you and Sarig, I feel like I can hold my own on the battlefield now.
I'd have to agree. The way you made short work of that last critter, I'd say it's time to find you a more worthy foe. Let's return to Mordzuk and plot our next course of action. You've proven the perfect mentor for the boy, Delara. Hells, I dared say old Sarik here can learn a thing or two from you. You've taught him not only how to wield his spells in battle, but how to maintain his focus in the face of danger. With those fundamentals under his belt, it is just a matter of time and practice until he's ready to face Phronēsis.
I promise you, my friends, I will not let you down. Now, if you'll excuse me, I best go and write down all I've learned today while it's fresh in my memory.
Such passion and determination. This must be the boy he always was, for his time beyond the rest stole from him his memories and his spirit. He devotes himself to his training that he might help us fell Phronēsis and bring his friend a measure of salvation. There is no telling what course the battle will take. I suspect the boy will be forced to confront his past head on. It will not be easy for him, and yet I believe it is a necessary step for him in order to forge himself a new future. For Tanner's sake, and for the sake of those you call Armorang home, we must triumph in this battle. Not to mention for the sake of our coin purses, eh? At any rate, I will leave you to your training and return to my own. The final confrontation is close at hand. We must be ready. Well, look who's back. And looking more imposing than ever, I must add. You'll be pleased to know that Tanner's command of his magic has advanced by leaps and bounds since you've left. Says he's finally convinced he can hold his own against Phronēsis. Truth be told, I worry about the boy. As devoted as he is to his training, I can't help but notice a sad, uneasy look in his eyes from time to time. He insists it's nothing, of course, but I remain unconvinced. As a fellow mage, perhaps you could succeed in reaching out to him where I failed. He should be around here somewhere,
Go and find him and see if you can offer him a few words of support, won't you?
Oh, hello there, Delara. Is there something I can do for you?
Sarek was worried about me, you say? That is, kind of him.
I assure you, I'm completely fine. I owe so much to the both of you. You brought me back from beyond the rift, took me under your wing, trained me and comforted me to the point that my memories and my magic have both returned. I'm finally ready to face my old friend in battle, and it's all because of you. And yet, there's a fear growing inside me, a fear that threatens to consume me. In my studies, I have learned much about the Sin Eaters. I learned how those who fall to the most powerful Sin Eaters like Phronēsis become Sin Eaters themselves, doomed to live out their days as mindless, unholy abominations. If I were to lose my focus in battle, and you or Sarek suffer the same fate as Nilbert, the only three friends I have known in this world, if I lost you all, how could I ever live with myself again? This thought shakes me to my very core. Sarek is saying that I should free my mind of distractions and focus on the task at hand. Perhaps you're right. Worrying endlessly about things beyond my control will only serve to break my focus. Thank you, friend. The task is a daunting one, but I will trust in myself and in the strong and gentle friends who stand by my side. Nothing would make me happier than help Nelber find peace, but that's not the only reason I fight this battle. I must repay you and Sarek for all you have given me. Not only did the two of you bring me back to this world, you have instilled me with a newfound sense of purpose. And yet, when the battle is done, you will leave this place. You will embark on new adventures with new companions. Worry not. I will not hold you back or stand in your way. That is another reason I must fight this battle. I must prove to you, to all three of my friends, that I am strong enough to get by on my own. Be strong, Tanor. You can do this. Sorry, perhaps I got a little carried away there. In any event, we should go tell Sarek that I'm ready.
You're finally back, I see.
I was starting to get worried. I trust this means you're ready to do battle with Phronēsis. I am! Let's put an end to this nightmare and set Nelber and the people of this land free.
That's the spirit?
Alright. The plan is to lure Phronēsis to us by the same method as last time.
We will venture to the central hills of Amber, a safe distance away from the city. And Tanor will summon forth the Hollow. It should only be a matter of time before our quarry arrives.
I believe our chances are best if we can lure Phronēsis to a wide open space, where we will have complete freedom to maneuver. The Hills of Amber should suffice. If you are ready, let us away at once.
Over there! It's him!
Yes, I knew you would come. Well, I guess we won't be needing this anymore. Give it up, Nelbert. My spell is more than a match for your own. These are my friends, and I will not let you take them. Do you hear me, Nelbert? Your long nightmare and ours shall end this day.
Forgive me, Tanner. Far and wide did I travel with my companions, all the while searching for a way, anyway at all, to bring you back to this world. And yet, in the end, it was all in vain. Though I treasure the adventures I had with Arbor and the others, my choice that fateful day forever haunted me. What if I'd run off with the stone and used its power to rescue you as I had always intended? What adventures might we have shared? I sunk into the depths of despair and felt myself a wretch for doing so. Or by what right do I pity myself when it was I who consigned you to far more cruel and tragic a fate? Whatever pain, whatever loss I know is nothing compared to what you suffered, what you still suffer. Abandoned by your only friend, cast adrift in a cold, dark void until the end of time? Yes, no doubt you are still out there beyond the rift, cursing my name to this very day.
That's not true, Nalbert. I'm right here.
And yet, even if you despise me with every fiber of your being, even still, I would give anything to see you just one last time. You could curse me, revile me, rain fists and magics down upon me. It would all be worth it, just for the chance to say, I'm sorry.
Stop it now, Bert. Please. Stop saying those things.
Even after you had your mind, your heart, your very humanity ripped from you, still, for all these years you kept searching for me.
How could I ever hate my best friend? Don't you see, old friend? It was Alara here who brought me back to this world, but it was you who guided her to me. You have suffered long enough, my friend. I can take care of myself now. You need to worry about me no longer, so please, rest peacefully.
It's over. At last. You don't need to explain it to me. I know that the Nilbert we saw was just a memory, a reflection from the crystal, that my friend truly passed years and years ago. And yet, even if those words will never reach Nilbert, simply saying them aloud gave me a measure of peace. I have no regrets today. We should be getting back to town before any more sin eaters take notice of us, yes?
I'll say. After that battle, I could use a rest. And I reckon Delaria here could as well. Shall we head back to Mordsuk?
Well, if it isn't the woman the hour, I'm happy to report that tales of our triumph are already spreading across town like wildfire. Word has it the merchants are so grateful that they intend to sweeten the bounty with a generous personal reward.
My friends, I have no words to express my gratitude. Thanks to you, Nalbert has found peace and I can finally close the book on this chapter of my past. Every day, I thank the gods for having brought us together.
The feeling's mutual, lad. To be honest, I wasn't sure what to expect when you popped out of that hole. But it's been a pleasure having you at our side. So tell me, now that you've made peace with your past, what do you plan to do with your future?
You and Delara have trained me well, and I am quite confident that I can hold my own on the battlefield. Perhaps I will travel the land and see if I might use my abilities to help those in need.
If I didn't know better, I'd think those were the words of someone twice your age.
If that's truly your intention, then I have something of a plan. First, I'll need Delara here's permission. It's just a thought I had, but let's say we gave the lion's share of the bounty to Tanner here. I reckon he needs it more than we do, and besides, we couldn't have won the battle without him. I knew you'd feel the same. That's the least we can do to help the boy forge a path and a future for himself.
My friends, I can never take advantage of your kindness like that.
Think nothing of it. It's not easy for a boy your age to make his way in the world, and this is the least we can do. Think of it as a parting gift from your brother and sister in arms.
Thank you, Sirig. Thank you, Delara. As long as I live, I'll never forget your generosity.
Finally, I've one last proposal for you, if you're keen to hear it. There's this bounty hunter I know. He can hold his own with a bow, but he's always thought he could take on bigger marks if he had a skilled mage at his side. If you're looking for a partner, that is.
Sirig? You cannot possibly mean...
Of course I'm saying it. So what'll it be?
Yes, 1,000 times yes. Why, nothing would make me happier.
Then I suppose that settles it. Welcome aboard, lad. I've got a feeling that this is only the beginning of a rewarding relationship. And on that note, I do believe my new partner and I are off to the Crystarium to find ourselves a new mark. If it's not too much to ask, why don't you join us there? I still owe you your share of the bounty, and I reckon it'd be a good place to say our proper farewells. Ah, Delara. Glad you could join us. Tanner and I just arrived a short while ago ourselves. The boy's keen on starting his new life as a bounty hunter, to say the least. He's got no end of questions, that one, but there's only so much I can teach him. The rest will have to learn from experience, and so I intend to do what I can to show him the world, and keep him safe. So don't worry about us. Between my bow and his magics, I reckon we'll be able to hunt our own out there. That said, should we ever find ourselves on the trail of a particularly nasty foe, I hope you'll not be adverse to lending us your strength once more. Yes, somehow I have a feeling it won't take another 100 years for our paths to cross again. Until then, friend, stay sheltered in the shade.